Hello guys, kumusta? Now I will be discuss about the inductive and deductive reasoning with a Kinkin puzzle. Now, inductive reasoning is the process of reaching a general conclusion by examining specific examples. Example 1. Use inductive reasoning to predict the number in each of the following list. Letter A, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. Ano kaya ang sunod sa 15? Okay, correct. Each successive number is 3 larger than the preceding number. Thus, we predict that the next number in the list is 3 larger than 15, which is 18. Okay, tama yung hula nyo. Letter B, 1, 3, 6, 10, 15. In 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wala. Okay, ganito yan. Yung dalawang numbers, kunin nyo ang kanilang difference. So, 3 minus 1, 2. 6 minus 3, 3. 10 minus 6, 4. 15 minus 10, 5. So, anong napansin nyo? Yung difference nila is ascending. 2, 3, 4, 5. Anong sunod? Okay, 6. Now, add 15 plus 6 is okay, 21. So, the first two number differ by 2. The second and the third numbers differ by 3. It appears that the difference between any two numbers is always 1, more than the preceding difference. Since 10 and 15 differ by 5, we predict that the next number in the list will be 6 larger than 15, which is 21. So ganun yung technique guys ha. Kung ang given ay hindi predictable, so gagawin nyo is i-subtract or depende sa given. Yung ibang given is kukunin yung square, saka i-subtract. Ito, iba yung atake niya. Okay, check your progress. Use inductive reasoning to predict the number in each of the following list. Letter A, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. Letter B, 2, 5, 10, 17, 26. Okay, comment below your answers. Example 2. Use inductive reasoning to make a conjecture. Consider the following procedure. Okay, ito guys ha. Bibigyan ka ng procedure. Ang procedure mo is pick a number. Multiply the number by 8. Add 6 to the product. Divide the sum by 2 and subtract 3. Complete the above procedure for several different numbers. Use inductive reasoning to make a conjecture about the relationship between the size of the resulting number and the size of the original number. Okay, now, sabi niya dito guys, pick a number. So, ikaw na bahala kung anong number ang gusto mo i-pick. So, solution, suppose we pick 5 as our original number. Then, the procedure would produce the following results. So, ito guys, kunwari lang guys, yung ipipick natin nga number is 5. But you can choose with whatever you want number. Pwede ka mag 6, pwede ka mag 7, pwede ka mag 100, pwede ka mag 1 million. It's up to you. Now, suppose we pick 5. Then, multiply the number by 8. Susundin lang natin tong procedure guys. So, our original number is 5. So, multiply by 8. So, 5 times 8 is 40. Next niya is add 6. Add 6. Then, 40 plus 6 equal 46. So, kung anong answers ng 5 times 8 is na 40, yun i-add mo. Next, divide by 2. So 46 divide by 2 equal 23, and subtract 3. So 23 minus 3 is 20. So anong napansin nyo guys? From original number naging 20. What do you think? Yung original number natin naging 20. So anong napansin nyo? Okay. So we conjecture that the following the given procedure produces a number that is 4 times the original number. So yung original number natin nga 5 naging 4 times. So 5 times 4, 4 times man, 5 times 4 is 20. Okay ba? Okay, another original number. Kanina 5 yung gamit natin. Ito naman ngayon. So let's try another number, original number, which is 7. Okay, consider the following procedure. Pick a number, multiply the number by 8, and 6. Add 6 to the product, divide the sum by 2, and subtract 3. Complete the above procedure for several different numbers. Use inductive reasoning to make a conjecture about the relationship between the size of the resulting number and the size of the original number. Okay, solution. Suppose we pick 7 as an original number. Then the procedure would produce the following results. So kanina, ginamit natin nga original number is 5. So titingnan natin itong original number na 7. Kung the same, kung yung number ba niya, mag-result ba ng 4 times. Okay, original number 7 multiply by 8. 8 times 7 equals 56, add 6, and 56 plus 6 is 62, divided by 2, 62 divided by 2 equals 31, subtract 3, 31 minus 3 equals 28. So we conjecture that the following the given procedure produces a number that is 4 times the original number. So kung titingnan nyo guys, 7. At ito yung result niya is 28. 7 times 4, 7, 14, 21, 28. So, 4 times the original number. So, kahit anong number ang gamitin nyo as original number, magiging 4 times yan. Kasi, yung procedure niya is para talaga sa pang 4 times. So, depende yan ha. Hindi lahat. Not all procedures are 4 times the original number. It depends the given of the procedure. Okay, let's try. Okay, next, check your progress. Consider the following procedure. Pick a number, multiply the number by 9, add 15 to the product, divide the sum by 3, and subtract 5. Complete the above procedure for several different numbers. Use inductive reasoning to make a conjecture about the relationship between the size of the resulting number and the size of the original number. So, ito guys, meron na kayong procedure ha? So, comment below your answers. Deductive reasoning is the process of reaching a conclusion by applying general assumption, procedures, or principles. Example 3. Use deductive reasoning to show that the following procedure produces a number that is 4 times the original number. Ito guys ha, binigyan tayo ng condition ni deductive reasoning. Dapat daw, yung result natin is 4 times. Yun kanina, sa inductive, di natin alam kung ilang times yung result sa number natin. Pero ngayon, binigyan tayo ni deductive. Sabi ni deductive, dapat maging 4 times ang original number natin. So, mayroon na tayong clue. Mayroon na tayong patutunguhan na dapat yung answer natin is magiging or maging 4 times. Now, in deductive reasoning, guys, dapat ang gagamitin mo nga number is variable. Hindi yung usual nga literal nga number. Sa inductive reasoning, ang gagamitin mo is yung number talaga, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But in inductive reasoning, dapat ang gamitin mong number is letters, variables. Pwede ka gumamit ng A, B, C, D, lahat ng letter, kahit anong letter. Basta, yan ang gamitin mo pag deductive reasoning. Guess nyo ba? Okay. So, solution, let N represent the original number. Ang ginamit niya dito nga variable, guys, is N. Pwede kang gumamit ng A, pwede kang gumamit ng X, pwede kang gumamit ng Y. It's up to you. As long as variables A, B, C, D up to Z. So, ang ginamit niya dito is N. So, original number is N. Now, multiply by 8. Ito yung, ano niya, ito yung procedure niya. Multiply by 8. So, 8 times N equal 8N. And then, add 6. O, tingnan nyo. Add 6 to the product. Yung product, yung result nila. So, 8N plus 6 equal 8N plus 6. Hindi mo pwede i-add sila, i-combine yan si 8N plus 6 dahil wala, hindi sila like terms. Ha? Baka i-add nyo yung 8 plus 6, hindi pwede yan. Dapat like terms. Okay, next. Divide by 2. So, 8N plus 6 over 2. So, 8 divided by 2 is 4. Copy N plus 6 divided by 2 is 3. Next, subtract 3. So, 4N plus 3 minus 3. 3 minus 3, 0. So, ang natira is si 4N. Okay. We started with N. So, nag-start tayo ng N. Ha? Start tayo ng N. And ended with 4N. The procedure given in this example produces a number that is 4 times the original number. Okay, ha? Ito si 4. At ito si N. 4N. So, 4 times N. 4 times the original number. So, nag-gets nyo, guys? Ha? So, sa deductive reasoning, guys, sa deductive reasoning, ibibigay na sa iyo kung saan ka patungo or ano dapat yung solusyon na kukunin mo. Sa madaling salita, may answer ka na. Binigyan ka na ng answer ni deductive. Ang hahanapin mo na lang is yung procedure, yung solusyon. Yun na lang ang gagawin mo. Pero alam mo yun na yung answer mo is 4N. 4 times the original number. So, ayan guys ha. Sana naintindihan nyo. Okay, check your progress. Use deductive reasoning to show that the following procedure produces a number that is 3 times the original number. O, ito guys ha. Dapat yung ending ng solution mo or yung procedure mo is 3 times the original number. Okay, again ha, again. Sa deductive reasoning, ang gagamitin mo nga number is variables. Gets nyo? So, pick a number. Deductive reasoning ito. So, anong gagamitin nyo? Variable. Either A, B, C, D, as long as letters. For inductive reasoning, ang gagamitin nyo is yung literal nga number talaga. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on and so forth. Okay ba? Yung procedure niya. Pick a number. Multiply the number by 6. Add 10 to the product. Divide the sum by 2. And subtract 5. Okay, hint. Let X represent the original number. Okay, hint lang na niya. So, pwede kang gumamit ng any number, any original number, which is A, B, C, D. Yung dito, binigyan ka lang ng ano, baka di mo gustong gamitin si X. Okay. So, comment below your answers. Counter example. A statement is a true statement provided that it is true in all cases. If you can find one case for which a statement is not true, called a counter example, then the statement is false statement. So, ito guys. Yung counter example guys, ito yan. So, dapat humanap ka ng isang number or isang example na yung true statement maging false. Humanap ka ng isang numero. O, isang numero. na magpapatunay na yung statement na yan is false. So that what we call counter example. Okay. Example 4. Find a counter example. Verify that each of the following statements is a false statement by finding a counter example. I-verify natin na itong mga given statement is false. So hanap tayo ng counter example. Hanap tayo ng mga numbers na itong mga given ito is false. Okay, letter A, absolute value of x greater than 0. Okay, letter B, x squared greater than x, and C, square root of x squared equal x. Okay, solution. A statement may have many counterexample, but we need only find one counterexample to verify that the statement is false. Okay, guys, isang counterexample lang hahanapin natin to make this statement false. Okay ba? So, let x, so mag-represent tayo ng mga numbers. So, let x equal 1. So, absolute value of 1. So, ito si 1 is substitute natin or i-replace natin kay 1. Absolute value of 1 is greater than 0. Then, the absolute value of 1 is 1. 1 is greater than 0. True or false? Mas malaki pa ba yung value ni 1 kay kang 0? Okay, it is true statement. So, 1 is greater than 0. So, this is true. But, we will find 1. Ha? We need only find one counter example to verify that the statement is false. Okay, now. So, find another example. Let x equal 0. Oh, ito na naman yung gamitin natin, 0. Kanina, kung si 1 ang gagamitin natin, so 1, 2, 3 is greater than 0. All positive numbers is greater than 0. Okay, para hindi siya maging greater than 0, so pababa tayo. Start tayo ng 0, negative 1, negative 2, ana. Okay, let's proceed. Let x equal 0. So, absolute value of 0 greater than 0. 0 greater than 0. Is it true or false? Hindi ba 0 equal sila dapat? So, 0 is not greater than 0. It should be 0 equal 0. So, false statement. Since napatunayan na natin nga this is a false statement, ito yung hinahanap natin nga counter example. Okay, guys? Ko isa lang, isa lang ginamit ko, let x equal 0. Okay na, this is a false statement. Ha? Because 0 is not greater than 0, we have a counter example. Pwede kayong gumamit ng other numbers kung gusto nyo, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. Okay ba? Dapat, ito ha, tandaan nyo palagi, we need only find one counter example to verify that the statement is false. So, gagawin nyo dito sa counter examples, guys. Umanap kayo ng paraan para maging false yung statement. Nag-guess nyo ba? Okay. Okay, guys. Okay, letter B, x squared greater than x. So, let x equal 4. So, kayo na bahala, guys, kung anong number nga gusto nyo gamitin. Sa akin, yung ginamit ko is 4. Pero sa inyo, kayo na bahala. Okay, so, i-replace lang natin yung si 4 sa x. Yung statement natin is x squared greater than x. So, i-replace natin ito si 4 sa mga x. So, 4 squared greater than 4. And then, 4 squared is 16 greater than 4. So, anong napansin nyo? True, false. Okay. True statement. Because 16 is greater than 4. Okay. So, hindi ito ang hinahanap natin nga counter example. Ipinapakita ko lang sa inyo yung true statement. But, we need only find one counterexample to verify that the statement is false. Ah. So let x equal 1. So hanap tayo. Okay. So ano lang natin si 1 na ilagay natin sa x. So 1 squared greater than 1. 1 squared is 1. Is 1 greater than 1? False statement. Dahil 1 is equal 1. Hindi naman 1 is greater than 1, di ba? So false statement. So itong hinahanap natin. Isang false statement. So because 1 is not greater than 1, we have a counter example. Okay, okay. Ikaw yung nabahala, ah. Kaya nabahala gumamit ng kahit anong klaseng numero. As long as mahanap nyo ang false statement. Gets ba? Okay, letter C. Square root of x squared equal x. So, ipapakita ko muna sa inyo yung true statement. Let x equal 2. So, si 2, ilagay natin dito sa x. Replace 2 to x. Replace x with 2. So, square root of 2 squared. Diba yung x natin is equivalent to 2. So, 2 equal 2. So, 2 squared is 4. Now, square root of 4 is 2. 2 equal 2. So, equal. That is true statement. Dahil equal sila. Okay. Let's try another. Let x equal negative 2. So, i-replace natin si x by 2. So, substitute. Negative 2 squared equal negative 2. So, si x is negative 2. X is negative 2. Now, negative 2 squared is positive 4 equal negative 2. And then, square root of 4 is 2 equal negative 2. O, tingnan nyo. Equal ba si 2 at saka si negative 2? Yung isa positive, yung isa negative. So, that is false statement. Dahil hindi sila magkapareho. 2 is not equivalent ba of negative 2. Okay? Because 2 is not equal to negative 2, we have a counter example. Okay, ito lang hinahanap natin. Ito lang hinahanap natin, ha? So, check your progress. Verify that each of the following statements is a false statement by finding a counter example for all number x. Letter A, x over x equal 1. Letter B, x plus 3 equal 3. X plus 3 over 3 equal x plus 1. Letter C, square root of x squared plus 16 equal x plus 4. Okay, comment below your answers. Kaya nyo yan, guys. Okay, hito na tayo. Ken-ken puzzle. Okay, rules for solving a ken-ken puzzle. For a 3x3 puzzle, fill in each box or square of the grid with one of the numbers 1, 2, 3. Dahil 3x3, dapat yung mga numbers nga i-fill ninyo is 1, 2, 3 lang. For a 4x4 puzzle, fill in each box of the grid with one of the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. So, kung 4x4 puzzle man ta, so dapat 1, 2, 3, 4 lang yung number gamitin nyo. For a n by n puzzle, fill in each box of the grid with one of the numbers of 1, 2, 3 to the n. Kung 5x5 puzzle, so hanggang 5 lang yung ipi-fill in ninyo sa box. Okay, grids range in size from a 3x3 up to a 9x9. Okay. Rules. Do not repeat a number in any row or column. Okay, next. The number in each heavily outlined set of squares called cages must combine in some order to produce the target number in the left corner of the cage using the mathematical operations indicated. Cages with just one square should be filled in with a larger number. A number can be repeated within a cage as long as it is not in the same row or column. So, pwede magulit yung numero as long as hindi or not in the same row or column. So, tatandaan nyo itong mga rules, guys, ha. Okay, example. 3 by 3 puzzle. So, 6 plus. So, ang cover ni 6 plus, ito yung column. Ito yung row. So, ang cover ni 6 plus is column, first box, second box, third box. Ito yung boundary niya. Ito yung boundary. Si 3x, or 3 times, ito yung cover niya. Ito. Ito. Ayan, ayan, ayan. Si 5 plus, ito at saka ito. Yung mga walang dash, yung mga walang dash nga line, it means, yan ang boundary. Di ka pwedeng lumagpas dyan. At saka ito naman si 2, so kung walang sign nga, wala kayong sign na makikita, so copy lang yung number. Kung anong number na nandito, kunwari ito, just copy. Okay. 3 by 3 puzzle. So, dapat ang makikita nyo lang dito nga mga numbers from rows to column is 1, 2, 3. And then, again guys, no repetition in every rows and in every column. Okay, let's try. 6 plus. It means, 6 plus means, i-add nyo ang mga numbers 1, 2, 3. O, depende na kayo. As long as ang makikita nyo lang dito is 1, 2, 3 because 3, this is a 3 by 3 puzzle. Okay. Solution. Start tayo sa 6 plus. So, ano kaya mga number nga makikita sa 6 plus? 2 plus, dito naman. 3, dito naman. 1, oh. 2, 3, 1. Diba? Walang na ulit ka number. So, kung i-add mo, 2 plus 3 plus 1, 6 plus. O, yan ang ibig sabihin ng 6 plus. E, add mo daw. Tapos, if you are going to add the 3 numbers, it will result to 6. Okay. Next, 3 times. So, ano kayong mga numbers dito? Dapat walang, ano ha, walang repetition ha. So, first is 1. Dito. 3. At saka dito, 1. Okay. 1 times 3, 3. 3 times 1, 3. O, kung titingnan nyo sa yung kwan, rows niya, 2, 1, 3. O, no repetition. Ha? Dito naman, 2, 3, 1, no repetition. Next, 5 plus. Okay, dapat i-add natin yung dalawang number with no repetition sa row and column. 2. Anong i-add natin para maging 5? So, 3. Okay, so, 2, 3. So, 1, 2, 3. Yo. 1, 2, 3. Just, ito si 2. Wala siyang sign. Just copy. Ayan. So, complete na yung 3 by 3 puzzle natin. So, kung titingnan nyo, sige, 2, 1, 3. Ito naman, 3, 2, 1. 1, 3, 2. O, dito naman tayo sa column. 2, 3, 1. 1, 2, 3. 3, 1, 2. Okay, diba? Kung mapapansin nyo guys, hindi na uulit yung walang numero. Ah, na sa isang row o sa isang column nga magkapariho. So, bawal na magkapariho sa isang row at saka sa isang column, ha? Okay. 4 by 4 puzzle. So, yung dapat, yung makikita lang ang number dito is 1, 2, 3, 4 lang. Kanina, 1, 2, 3 puzzle man to. 3 by 3 puzzle. Ngayon, 4 by 4 puzzle. So, dapat, yung mga numbers na makikita dyan sa loob ng box are 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, simula tayo sa 6x. 6x means 6 times. So, ito lang yung cover niya. Ito nga box, ito na box, ito na box. Yung Ito na line ito. Ito yung boundary. Okay. So, let's try in the 6x. Okay. Solution. Let's try in the 6x. Okay, so hanap tayo ng mga numbers na once you multiply, the result is 6. Okay, let's try 2. Next, 1. 2 times 1 is 2. Next, 3. Okay, 3 times 2, 6 times 1, 6. Oh, yan, ang ibig sabihin ng 6x. Multiply mo mga numbers. Dito naman tayo sa 7. So, i-add mo yan ha. I-add mo sila. So, 3. Anong i-add natin? Okay, 4. So, 3 plus 4, 7. Okay, tingnan nyo. 2, 1, 3, 4. O, walang na-repeat nga numbers. Next, dito tayo kay 2. Okay. Since 2 is walang walang sign, just copy. Ha? Itong tandaan nyo yan na if the whole number, if the given number has no sign, just copy. Okay, next, 8x. So, i-cover ng 8x is ito na box, at saka ito na box, ha? Yung cover niya. So, let's try to 1. Next, 4. 4 times 1 is 4. Next, ano kaya susunod na number dito? 2. 2 times 4, 8. Times 1, 8. Okay. So, tingnan nyo. 2, 1, 3, 4. Walang naulit na number. 3, 2, 4, 1. O, wala pang naulit na number. Okay, next. Try natin si 4x. So, ito yung cover ni 4x. Ito yung cover ni 4x. Ha? Ito lang talaga. Ito lang talaga. Dalawa. Itong dalawa. Itong dalawang box. Okay. So, 1. 1 times ano? Okay, good. 1 times 4. 1 times 4 is 4. Okay. So, tingnan nyo, 2, 3, 1, 2. Okay. Ah, 2, 3, 1, 4 pala. 2, 3, 1, 4. So, walang naulit na number. Ito naman tayo kay 12. So, 12. Ano kayang mga numbers nga dapat natin ilagay dito? This is multiplication. So, 4. Next, 3. 4 times 3 is 12. Okay, next. Dito tayo kay 1. 1 is 1 and na may sign siya na negative. So, mag-subtract tayo. So, 3. So, anong isa-subtract natin para maging 1 siya? Okay, 2. So, 3 minus 2 is 1. O, yan ang ibig sabihin ng negative sign. At ito naman si 1, wala siyang sign, copy. Or operation. Another term for sign and operation, guys, ha? Wala siyang operation. Yung operation natin, guys, ganito. Addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. So, okay, gagamitin natin na term ngayon is operation para covered lahat. Ha? Okay, so just copy. At ito na lang kulang, 1. Okay, so anong napansin nyo, guys? Okay, babasahin natin na by rows and column. 2, 1, 3, 4. 2, 3, 1, 4. 3, 2, 4, 1. 1, 4, 2, 3. 4, 3, 1, 2. 1, 2, 4, 3. 3, 4, 2, 1. 4, 1, 3, 2. O, walang numero na bumalik. Ha? So, yan ang gagawin nyo. No repetition numbers inside the column and rows. Okay, check your progress. O, 3x3 puzzle. O, ito na gawin nyo ito, guys, ha. O, ito, 18x. So, it means multiply. Ito lang yung cover niya. Ito. Then, 4 plus. Ito, at saka ito. 1, 2, 3. At saka si 6x. O, ito yung cover niya. Next is a 5x5 puzzle. O, po ito. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ang gamitin nyo dito, ha. Sige. Okay, end of discussion. Thank you so much, guys. So, I hope you enjoyed our topic. See you next video. Don't forget to subscribe and comment your reaction. Thank you so much, guys.